Sir, I'm afraid I will not be agreeable to...
No, no, please, 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 ministers, don't even gesticulate or respond to anybody who is not authorized. It's very simple. And they'll be further encouraged.
With much distress, I have to go out.
Yes, yeah, good, that is nice. That is. Sir, I'm afraid I will not be agreeable to my friends from the ruling party, particularly the finance minister. She is not here. For the views I would express on budget, because I do not agree to most of them. There are good points, but when there are good points, they are with you, and we are all agreeing. They did not be repeated at all. Usually in a school of thought, two schools of thought, one really comes to it. Budget is not some kind of a magic wand where we expect everything from you. Nor preparation is that easy, wherein you can produce whatever you want. As a matter of fact, as Jairam ji yesterday said, the budget is not the budget presentation. There have been many pronouncements on the budget outside the budget presentation day, like corporate tax cut or even demonetization. They have an impact on the budget, but they have been done outside the budget. So that kind of a sanctity which you usually give is not there. Besides, budget is not one where all the people look to it as if something is going to happen. It is not be all and all of the thing. There is a time, there are going to be developments, there are going to be mid-course corrections, and all these things do go as far as the budget is concerned. My concern today is that we had a 2.5 hours rhetoric, sometimes very pleasing to ears, few of the phrases, but on the whole, disappointing in the sense we did not really address the issues that a budget should have done, otherwise done. A statement of a finance minister should have done. Because we are doing it at a time when the nation finds itself in a slowdown mood. Entire economy is on a slowdown mood. I did not give the total statistics because you have them with you. I do not repeat them also. But at the same time, it is better if you can look into the everything. You see, we have, as you know, the GDP has come down from 4.5 to 5%, and even your economic survey says it goes to 6%. It's all there. But please don't depend on GDP at all. This GDP is some kind of mystic thing. It is a myth, in my view. Come and build some building here. Let the United Nations headquarters come here and build the houses. Your GDP really goes up. What percolates down to people? What is your per capita income? What exactly is the impact and its effect on the people is what exactly is the gross income, not mere GDP. This, keeping that in view, let me tell you, we are in a very bad shape as far as the economy is concerned. And against such background, there is no stimulus. It could also be a strategy. You may not depend on stimulus. You may not depend on the borrowing things. You may only depend on growth. This is one way of thinking. The other way of thinking is we do need some kind of a stimulus, some kind of a incentives where the investment grows. What exactly engines of growth? Your investment, your consumption, your employment. These are three things which are concerning us today more than anything else. All things do add to them, but nonetheless, it is going to be there. Sir, the budget speech, as I said, the 2.5 hour speech, has been long in words, literature, but has been a non-event for a simple reason. You saw the BSE crashing down. And we were promised of the bright Monday, which did not come. I'm not trying to criticize it, but please tell me, might have come off way. That also I'll agree. Or might come next Monday. I would not bother about it. But see, another thing I would like to say as some kind of a prelude to what I'm saying. When we are talking against a particular issue or a particular figure, it is not because we're critical. We are not proud and saying something has gone wrong. It is our nation on which things have gone wrong. And we are also thinking, but the method that we have adopted the ideology we have adopted, the systems we have adopted have gone wrong, and which you might come and say that, look, this is what could have been done otherwise. This exactly need to be taken. For example, I give you few figures, because Shuklaji was giving yesterday entire figures. So was Mr. Ramchandra Prasad. He was also giving us the figures, because I did not hear Mr. Chidambaram. Perhaps he was trying to join some kind of a schism with Chidambaram and said it is not class versus mass sort of a thing. But let me tell you, figures are, everybody has the figures. What suits us best, we always give. But what exactly is going to be the basics and fundamentals, he was the clue. Today, industry is totally down. Investments are minus. Foreign exchange, though it has come picked up very little the other day, but still really at low. Don't look, as I said, Jayaraman said, don't look to the figures. Look to the rate of growth. Because incremental, in any budget, what we look to is an incremental thing. We don't look to what exactly is the figure. A large country like us will certainly have a good figure. A large country like America might certainly have a good figure. But the rate of increment is what exactly matters in economics, and not the total figure. Sir, I tell you about the, in terms of industries, 18 out of 23 industries, as per National Industrial Classification 2.8, two digital thing, the manufacturing sector has shown a negative growth during the month of October 2019. This everybody agrees. I will not go into much details except very important thing. It is a big list, which I won't repeat again. Similarly, consumer goods and durables, MFCG, are affected over as compared to the previous year, 6% in primary goods, 21% in capital goods, 92% in infrastructure and construction. The consumer goods and non-industry durables, 18%. The report further estimated that agriculture, forestry and fishing will grow by merely 2.8%. In fact, it was 2.1 in the first two quarters of the last financial year. I am saying this because yesterday you got up as if something wrong was said from this side, from the friends in the house. So I am trying to correct it. It is not only right figures. We must look to the industries. We must stick to construction. Because these are things which give employment. We must look to agriculture, we must look to fisheries, we must look to construction. That is why I picked up only those figures. The government has promised to double the income of every farmer by 2022. But with a growth of 2.8 and 2.1, which I have said, can we do it is another matter, unless we are trying to give some kind of incentives or some kind of stimulus. You have announced some kind of a 16-point program. But tell me, not only I'm not talking about allocation of the 16-point program, but 16-point program, the details of it have never gone into direct transfer of incomes there. So I doubt with that kind of a 16-point program, though welcome, with 16-point program I would not say is not right. It might be welcome, but it's not going to answer this particular issue. Thus, there has been a downfall in almost all sectors, which I say I'll skip. Now, even let us talk about the impact of net national income slowdown can also be seen as per capita income, which I said, which is more important, which during 2019-20 is estimated at ₹1,35,000 with a growth rate of 6.8%, whereas during 2018 it was 10.3%. So even that is coming down, and our concern should have been on that. It is not only RBI. It is you, most of you, the economists here, would agree that the increasing deficit or continuing deficit or persisting deficit is going to affect the incomes of the poor people, not the middle class or the rich class. That you must always keep in mind whenever you talk about the deficit. Sir, the biggest challenge before the government is whether to start them all today or wait for your own programs to materialize. Good. All the programs are good. How much they are being implemented, if you have some kind of a monitoring system with a monitoring committee, the other day said they are not being done to the expected levels. Now, I go to physical position. I am only trying to take it up. Yesterday when you talk about any reply, one by one you said, let us talk about the physical position. Sir, less revenue collection along with lower nominal GDP add to the risk of fiscal deficit and slippage. The total revenue receipts are estimated at 20 lakhs, and that is 9.23% higher because revised estimates you brought down, so it has gone up. It is not because they have gone up by themselves. So as for the capital, income is concerned, it is somewhere at 10.21 lakhs. So out of this share of borrowings constitute something like 8 lakh crores. That means what exactly left is through the borrowings. I'm happy at one stage that today in the budget, you are not resorting to the borrowings, you are only looking to the growth. But borrowings you are not doing, looking to the growth is all right. But what next you are doing, you are looking to the disinvestment. But what is your experience with disinvestment? For the last 22 years, 16 times you failed in your disinvestment figures. You have not achieved anything at all. I'm just telling you, 16 out of 22 years, the disinvestment figures have targets have never been reached. The major concern is that the revenue deficit is...
Okay, 1 minute. Your party has 17 minutes. You have taken just 11 minutes. Keep that in mind. Well, because there is one more speaker.
Keep that, yes, sir. I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah, please. Please.
So I'll end this. What I am trying to say is one matter. So this kind of a, at the fiscal stage also, we have done very bad. Revenue from disinvestment, you are expecting that will not fetch, as I said. And this, unfortunately, have included even life insurance, which has been paying you, which has been contributing to your regular budgeting. But income tax, I come to this. Income tax, you have mixed up two things, the old one and with the new one. We don't know which is going to help. All that is going to help is the chartered accountants, as Mr. Jairam yesterday said.
Right.
Because when the two things come, which one I should opt? But I was checking it with my own chartered accountant. He said, don't take the new one. Go for the old one, that will help you more. Whatever it is, even if everything is done, even if the new method is adopted, it is going to fetch you or save you 40,000 crores, which should not be a very big amount as far as you are concerned. Sir, my thing is, since I have no time, I have to take certainly not more than 1 or 2 minutes more. Sir, your absolute stepmotherly attitude towards state governments. Yesterday, Maharashtra, Odisha were complaining about that, even Madhya Pradesh. What is this all happening? You have, as the Finance Commission is comparing 42 to 41% because 1% is going to Jammu and Kashmir. We should have gone from your exchequer, your funds. You have taken out from here. And even this, don't think by 42%, 41%, don't believe in the 42 or 41, sir, because it might look 42. And as far as the 14th Finance Commission is concerned. But when you are taking out the actual collections, we take into account the actual collections, minus surcharges, minus cess, other things, it will come down to 32% to 33%. Same thing will happen as far as the 15th Finance Commission is concerned. When you take out the 41%, it actually comes down to 31%. Who is suffering? It is the states who are suffering. That thing we have not taken into consideration. As far as Telangana is concerned, we have really lost. You have promised us in the budget something like 2,900 crores, which is our due. It is my money which has gone to you. I have given 60,000 crores as a tax, and I'm supposed to take 50% of it at least. I'm making a very rough estimate. I'm not giving correct figures and looking to it because time is not there. So that money is being cut short because of your own idiosyncrasies. Sir, people are talking about Manrega. Manrega has come down. Yesterday, Mr. Ramchandra was saying that he belongs to village and he lives only in village. So he said, look, village positions are good. At least he meant the spirit of it, I'm trying to tell you. I wish that everybody is like Ramchandra as far as village is concerned. If every villager is nothing like Ramchandra Prasad, then we would not have any problem here in this house. Only because Even earlier we had this kind of a two-way lives here. But here it has gone to villages also now. So I am telling you, just let us not be happy that things in rural area are really good. As a matter of fact, rural incomes have come down by 2.1%. And their consumption has come down by 1.8%. So this is not there. I would say the budget recognized the stress of seriousness of the water. But unfortunately, the state government, Telangana government, had Bhagirathi mission. We give piped water to all the villages, spending something like 16,000 crores. We asked for 1,000 crores from the state, sir, from the center, which Niti Aayog has promised us, but it has not given a single paisa. Similarly, in the agriculture and allied things, you have come out with a big allocation, but there's no talk about our Kakatiya, which is supposed to be Asia's one of the biggest. And we have completed our role, sir, after requesting from you in this regard. Sir, after Kakatiya, resources to us, the Finance Commission, as I said, you promised us as far as GST is concerned that the day you started it, said 14% of any short, up to 14%, you take as the benchmark. And anything less than that 14%, you will compensate to the states. Till today, we have to get something like 3,000 crores as the dues, which is not coming. It's not me. It's almost all the states. I'm only talking here, states versus the center.
Right, Keshava Garu, your party time is over. Please conclude.
So one thing I would say, as I said, consumption people, sir. So this indifference to states issues, as I said, should go, and any budget should address the states must, because to my mind, the last word, excuse me for the word, center is merely a myth. It is some kind of our own boundaries which we have created, giving powers, so that governance is there. Otherwise, people live. People who want to enjoy are in the states, and they are found in the states.
Right.
So we have to do it, and this kind of discrimination, this kind of stepmotherly attitude towards states will not fetch us and will not take us to the targets that you want to
achieve.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Keshavaru. News subscribe cheyandi. Pakkane unde bell symbol no click cheyadam marchipokandi. Updates ni miss avvakandi.
Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, share. Follow on Facebook, Google+, Twitter, Instagram. For more updates, please subscribe Great Telangana TV.